Hey, my YouTube subscribers, I'm making this short video to talk to you about the power of resetting your frame of reference and toughening yourself up and why it's going to help you with your confidence. So what is it, resetting your frame of reference? Well, the way I see it, we got soft as a society. I mean, really think about it. You wake up in the morning, you can order your breakfast in if you want, right? You go, you can take a hot shower, you have your wardrobe with all the clothing, you can pick red or blue, whatever it is. We have infinite number of choices, right? Nobody will be shooting at you when you leave your building. I mean, obviously, it depends where you live, but if you're watching this video, I assume it won't happen. Now, if you get sick, you can go to the pharmacy. If you get really sick, they will take you to the hospital. I could give you many examples, but the point is very simple. Life became very easy. Now, of course, we rationalize in our heads why our lives are so difficult. We have all of those challenges. Oh my God, I may not close that $1 million deal, right? So this seems like the end of the world. But the reality is that all of those problems are the first world problems. And because of that, because of the fact that, you know, everything is so easy nowadays, many of us got so soft that whenever a bad situation happens to us, we don't know how to deal with it, right? Whether it's some type of heartbreak, right? Perhaps you lose your job or that business deal doesn't work the way you want it to go. Whatever it is, we find it very difficult to handle those situations. And that's why I believe that nowadays it's super important to reset your frame of reference, to toughen yourself up, to expose yourself to discomfort. So you train that muscle, and whenever something bad happens to you, you know how to deal with it. You know how you respond to certain situations. You know how to control your emotions. You know how to control how you view the world. So what I would suggest is, even though you have all the options in the world and you know how to live a comfortable life, push yourself consciously, at least I would say every few days, every week, to embrace the discomfort, right? Set up those small challenges that will reset that frame of reference. For example, when you wake up in the morning, and if you take an extremely cold shower for even 30 seconds, that's gonna be so tough. You know, when I take cold showers, so I know it's really tough. You're standing there, you know you wanna do it, but you don't wanna do it. And you almost like, it seems like you're praying, right? It's like, should I do it? I'm not sure. And then you do it and you feel this excruciating pain in your bones. But guess what? After 5-10 seconds, the pain is gone. After next 20-30 seconds, you kind of get used to it. And then you start feeling amazing, right? And most importantly, you know that you pushed yourself. You know that you embraced the discomfort. So later on throughout the day, when something bad happens, when your boss is an asshole today and he just keeps telling you what you should be doing, and you know that it's unreasonable, but he keeps telling you, or maybe you have problem with your spouse, or perhaps you're in a big traffic jam, all of those problems don't seem so big anymore, right? Because you started your day by facing a small challenge. Super important. Now, also, I would encourage you to set up those bigger challenges, right? I mean, cold shower, great stuff, but you can take it to the next level. And I would say at least once every few months, I really encourage you to have those bigger challenges. Maybe it's signing up for a Thai boxing camp, right? Maybe it's going into the woods by yourself and trying to complete a 25-kilometer hike/run. Just take a backpack, take some food, and try to do it by yourself, right? Even though it's cold, even though you feel like, your muscles are aching, you just keep going, just to show to yourself that you're capable of it. Because you see, what happens is every time you push yourself like this, whether it's physically or mentally, you keep sending that signal to your brain that you are capable of more than you thought. And because of that, when something really bad happens to you, when you get that midnight phone call and someone tells you, look, one of your best friends is in a hospital, right? He had a car accident. You will be more likely to manage your emotions well and to respond to that situation with a clear mind, all right? So don't be soft, toughen yourself up consciously. I can guarantee you that your level of confidence will grow, because when you think about it, what confidence is? Well, confidence, first of all, is feeling comfortable in your skin, right? It's believing in yourself, but it's also accepting yourself the way you are. So of course, you want to improve yourself on a daily basis, but at the same time, you already accept yourself the way you are. Because of some failure, you don't slap yourself in the face saying, you know what, I don't think that you are good enough. No, you are good enough as a human, right? You appreciate yourself, but you want more at the same time. However, you know, I feel like one of the best ways to build that true confidence is to show to yourself that you are truly capable of more than you thought you were, right? So that's why, for that reason, I feel like, you know, this exercise of embracing discomfort and purposely toughening yourself up will actually increase your level of confidence, not just in short term, because obviously in short term you will feel that spike of confidence, but I feel like if you keep embracing those challenges, you know, week after week, then in long term your confidence will keep growing, right? Don't take my word for it, just try it for yourself. You have nothing to lose. And let me know what you think. Post a comment. By the way, don't forget to subscribe to those videos. This year I plan to make many more videos. All right, last year I was slacking, to be totally honest with you. I think I posted like 10 or 15 videos in 2019. This year I'm posting a ton of content, so stay tuned. Watch out for my videos. Guys, wish you a great day. See you soon.